What up, YouTube? It's your boy GGJ Fly Guy here, back again with another update on the DM-1. Just a quick update on the DM-1, and a shout out and a quick unpackaging. DM-1, as you can see, she's back together. We got the pinion back on. Use a red lock tight this time. We'll take it out again for another shakedown. And hopefully, this time we'll get the GPS on it just to see what my speed is. On 4S, still, I'm going to get it. I'm going to do a couple more shakedowns just to make sure everything's good to go on this bad boy before I try to hit a good speed run. But anyway, she's back up and running. I'm on pause with the racing setup. I got another part coming in. I'll do an unboxing on that once it arrives. Just something that's going to make switching from the speed setup to the racing setup a lot easier and quicker. But anyway, once that part comes in, I'll get it all set up and I'll do another a video on it. And I'm still waiting on some more parts for the GTV. Real quick, I'm going to pull this off the stand. And I want to do a shout out. I actually did an official unboxing, or I thought I did an official unboxing. But I had my little man recording for me. He decided to volunteer. Little did I know, he recorded most of what he recorded was me talking and the back of his finger. I'm using my iPad. I'm not really sure how he managed to do that, but the whole video is kind of jacked up. There's no editing or salvaging it. It's all finger and me talking. So anyway, I'm gonna take this off, and then I'm gonna do a shout out real quick, and you guys will understand why here in a second. First, I'm going to give a shout out to my man, Rock Bud. Rock, here she is. Thanks, bro. It has sure come in handy, especially with working on this this car. A lot easier to deal with than my old one, which wouldn't turn and usually wanted to just tip over whenever I put one of the 8 scales on it. It would do okay with 10 scales. It still wouldn't turn, but at least it wouldn't tip over. But with this one, my man, it is primo. For you guys who don't know, I had inquired with Rock Bud about purchasing one of these, and he sent me information. He was giving me information, but then decided to donate the one he had to me. Rock, dude, man, you don't know how much this means to me. Thank you. I appreciate it. This will get some use, especially with me trying to update these cars. I love this thing. It will go in my track bag also when I go to the track, so I have a stand to at least work on when I need to. I appreciate you, bro. Gotcha. Good looking out. Thanks for that. It is sure nice. If you guys can see, there's a magnetic strip down here to hold parts to keep them from sliding around. And then a tray to capture other parts that maybe not magnetic. I put some foam tape on top just to keep my aluminum. Most of my cars are aluminum bodies, and one, keep them from getting scratched up. Two, that just grips a little bit better with that foam up there. And then when I turn it, it's not sliding around. So, but anyway, Rock, thank you, my man. Big shout out. Good looking out. Thanks a bunch. So let's get to the unbagging. These parts are starting to come in. I'm not really sure what this one is, but these are. But I got quite a few coming in to start working on getting the GTV back up where it needs to be. I kind of put the motor on pause for a minute. I was talking to my man, Tin Man, about it. A motor that he is using, and I think I'm going to go with that one. Okay, yep. That is another Fly Sky receiver. I'm going to change out the receiver in my GTV to Fly Sky. And the reason why I'm doing that is because the Fly Sky will allow me to set my exponential on the steering. I did notice one thing on that track with the back end kicking out quite a bit. Even with the tires that I was using, it was still kicking out. And I can run some negative exponential to help resolve that issue. That's just a trick I learned from running my 10 scales on the track here in the area where I live at. A couple of the really diehard racers taught me. You can run negative exponential to keep the back end from overpowering the front end and sliding out constantly, going around turns. It also helps you get through those turns quicker. Second part to come in right here. Team C front shocks, and I actually today ordered the rear, so I'm going to change them out completely to adjustable shocks on the GTV, front and rear, just to get a better ride height on the track. I did notice, like I said, it was riding a little high, And if I can get it a little bit lower and lower the center of gravity, it's going to also help getting around some of those turns and stuff at the track. So that's what we got on these two parts so far. Still waiting on some other stuff to come in. Once those do, we'll get them doing unboxing on them. And then we'll start to get the GTV back up to where she needs to be. Anyway, that's what we got.